brought the tigers in, cause I was busy earning stripes like a tiger skin. Layers and ball shorts, coaching from the side of the ball court. If you know, you know. One stop.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with Andrew Luck and the Indianapolis Colts. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he was. Would have been if he'd taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line.
Let it roll, let it roll, let it roll.
A run by Mack to start the drive, and he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Next, the receivers helped spread the defense out, and they were able to come through with a slashing run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
The first carry for Josh Adams. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a third down. Now Love. And this one complete right side to Funchess. He's got the first down and more past the 40. Give the Colts 13 yards and a first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
And he'll take this for about 4 up to the 46-yard line. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
On second down, here's Love. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. That one goes for 36 yards.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him, as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. That little arc on it, he's got to find a way to get his head around and make the play on the football.
Here's Mack on the toss. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 11 more on that one, and another first down. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking. It's helped keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle, and they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering.
Now he's got his target. It's caught for a Colts touchdown. Eric Ebron, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Colts take it right down and score on the opening drive. Vinatieri able to tack on the PAT. And it's now a 7-0 game. Vinatieri out there to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
40, 82, 40.
Shotgun now for Wentz. And incomplete to open things up. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver. And it's second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
Play action. Now Wentz. And that's going to be incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time. And that takes us from second to third down. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
17 yards is the pickup there for number 17. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now a play fake. Wentz. He's got the hook up here to DeSean Jackson. A big play there on the catch and run. 51 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
We got three. Into the red zone. Wentz. This is taken in by Jeffrey. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Alshon Jeffrey, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Eagles are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And he's got it up and through. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And the Colts getting ready to go. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are. But with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
Luck and the Colts come up now first and 10 at the 20. From the gun, here's Luck. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
And that'll set them back five. And that false start penalty is certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much there at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line. Tackle made there by Zach Brown.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll run with a former Badger. It's Corey Clement. And a solid run down inside the 30. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
On play action, Wentz. Right side caught by Jackson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. Wentz now on first down. Got a man open. It's Ertz. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Carson Wentz with 2 first-half touchdown passes. And the Eagles are able to cash it in for 6. Elliott Good with a PAT. And that makes the score 14-7. Elliott now to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Colts offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. They'll run it now out of the gun. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. It'll only be a gain of 1 yard, and it sets up a 3rd down and 4 now.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. On first down, Adams. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
Love the run right there, and when you analyzed him coming out of college, when you tried to put a grade on him, you saw the flashes while he was in school, but you didn't see the full production. You didn't see the finished product. He's a little bit raw, but you can see why people liked him. Those types of runs make you think there's plenty more there, and we'll see if that continues for him.
Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. They'll run on first down. Adams. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Here's Luck now on second down. That is caught at the 7. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. It's second and goal, back to the 8-yard line now. He'll get it up the middle, and he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to set up a third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Here's Luck. Trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
So that's back-to-back drives where they're throwing an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. On play action, it's Wentz. Throwing for his running back, he's got him complete. And he's able to get up here to the 26. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout, as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. They face a third and 4 after that last completion gets them 6. They fake the give. Now Wentz. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket.
Go, go.
Here we go on fourth down with Wentz. Escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to go deep down the left side. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense, as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. On first and 10, here's Wentz. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he gets it down to the 32. Give him three on the play, and it'll make it second down. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. And it's no good. Elliott pulled it, and this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And Luck will be intercepted for a third time. Picked off by Avonte Maddox. So we've come to halftime here in Philly with the Eagles on top. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Gets fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. And the last time that they were on the field, a little demoralizing. Missed field goal. You always feel like you want to get it in the end zone, but then, oh, well, at least we're going to get three. Didn't go through the goalpost, so.
It does test the mental processes of the team, though, doesn't it? Because when you miss a field goal, it's amazing how fast they want to turn on the guy kicking the ball. But you need to keep his confidence up because how many times have we seen games where it comes down to a stretch? And guess what? You need that guy to make the big kick for your team to move on or to win a game. Make sure you keep him happy. Make sure you keep him comfortable.
I'm sure you always treated the kicker nicely, though, right?
You know, truthfully, I did. I always did because those guys, they won us a whole lot of games.
That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Nice movement there by Carson Wentz outside of the pocket. Completes another pass. Help me out here, partner. He's not sneaky athletic. He is athletic. How many times do I have to say it?
Yeah, you've been making that declaration for a while. And at 6'5", he ran a 40 of 4.77. So not only big, but he can move.
That's a good time for a quarterback. He and Andrew Luck, similar physiques, similar athletic ability.
Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41. They'll run it now out of the gun. Flash the stick skills on that run, but then stop shy of the 35 and give the tackle to Anthony Walker.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. They give him 12 yards and a first down.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
Thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
He's going to cut. Going to 6. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. Now, on that play, he's able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
Here's Wentz to throw. Got a man open. It's Ertz. Touchdown, Philadelphia. 3 touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And the Eagles add on to their lead. A good sustained drive there in this third quarter, capping it off with a touchdown to give them a nice 2-score advantage.
It was actually a fun one to watch, wasn't it? I mean, for me, seeing the mix of what they did, how they moved the ball downfield, very sharp, too. Each and every play seemed to be executed with great dispatch.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here's the Colts now as they get ready for their first possession on offense of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half,
Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things work well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
Call.
To throw on second down is up. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Good yardage there for the Colts. 18 and a first down. On first and 10, Locke. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that'll make it second and 12.
Middle.
They'll run it now. Out of the gun. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a third and 11. He really hasn't been able to get on track running the football, averaging less than 4 yards a carry.
Yeah, I think that they're going to enjoy the film session because all the defenders are filling their proper gaps on just about every play. And you know what they always say for a defensive coach, when I click off this film, I better see 11 jerseys.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. And that gives him now 3 interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get 3 in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
With the Eagles.
That's right. Then with the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. That's caught inside the 20. Wentz able to hook up with Aguilar for a big gain. 42 yards.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
From the red zone now, Wentz able to get away. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
One thing that I liked about this guy during the draft process was his motor. Of course, I loved his skills, but he plays hard on every down.
And that motor on full display there as he gets his first NFL sack. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. The Eagles on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to make it fourth down. Well, a clear running situation, trying to take time off the clock. You ran the previous play, set that play action up nicely.
Boy, did they ever, because they had shown the ability to run the football, so now you lose your keys as a defense. You dive for the running play, and they hit them over the top.
So with that, you figure, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from 3 scores down, but don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily that you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Fletcher Cox with a great push up front. He picks up the sack and a loss of 8. Luck and the Colts looking for something big here after the sack. This is third and long. Here's Luck. Flushed out right. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But we also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done. But Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. But they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bifema Bradley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. This is Clement. And not much of an opening there as he's only going to get this to about the 32. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. The Eagles indeed snap it. Wins. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. A big pickup of 12 yards on fourth down to keep this drive from stalling. Wentz now a perfect 8 for 8 to start the second half. Not bad. First and 10. Ertz has it left side. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. A good pickup there. 26 yards. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
Wentz now to throw. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 16. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
Brandon, these cornerbacks had their hands full all afternoon long, but they finally get a measure of revenge as he gets himself in a nice spot. He's able to get two hands on the football and pick it off.
Back to throw, Locke. Ebron with it over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down. Now Locke. Looking deep for Hilton. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Jalen Mills. And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran the wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
23 yards on the play. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. They go play action here on first down. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. A run, it's Clement. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. It'll be a gain of 2 on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with third down looming. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches. Oh, look at this. Wentz gonna throw. Throw left side complete. That's Jackson. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. They'll run with Clement, and he'll get this one down to about the 27. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be 3rd and 3 now. And they just took a timeout. With 2 seconds to go, this one obviously decided. Not sure they needed to take it, but we'll take it with them. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add 3 more, a little insult to injury here late in the game. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And the kick is good. So you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But in